it's not as gray as mine, so we won't touch that. But we thank God for them. They both have lived here, Texas, New Mexico, Arizona, all over, right? And they're spreading one thing, the good news of Christ, right? So we thank God for them. And I talked to Brother Richard, we don't want to supersede what God has given us as far as the authority, but Richard wanted to share a couple of things with you before she brings the teaching.
My precious helping my meeting is acknowledging that she's under God's authority, and they're both under the pastor's authority, and she's under my authority. She's not usurping authority, as somebody might say. This is a woman called of God, gifted communicator, and as Pastor and I were talking, why don't we give Naomi an opportunity to share the word on Mother's Day? So again, it's in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that I bless my wife, and I ask God to use her in the name of Jesus. Father, Pastor, and then I pray blessing and favor upon Naomi. God, give her clarity of thought and a special grace and anointing from on heaven. Use the word of God. Use your instrument to bring forth the word on this wonderful Mother's Day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
God,
praise the Lord. I come to you this morning with fear and trembling. Fear, because I'm before an almighty, powerful God.
What?
The great I am. So I'm in fear before him, in reverence before him. But I'm trembling because my husband's here. And he's going to hear what I've got to say. And I'm trembling because my brother, the pastor of this church, is here too, and he's another pastor. So, you know what I mean. I mean, yeah. I'm with fear and trembling.
God's going to use you.
But I know that I know that I know that God has a word for us. God. And my prayer is that I will not get in the way of what he wants to say. Because when I get in the way, things don't go good. But when we give him liberty to talk and say what he wants to say, he's going to say it.
Amen.
And my prayer is that you will receive it not from a woman up here, but from a servant of God.
Amen.
Let's talk to him. Father God, I want to say thank you for this opportunity, because you know that you have put this message in my heart, and I prayed, and I prayed, and I prayed, and you are giving me this opportunity to speak your word this morning. I pray, Lord God, that you might take captive every thought to the obedience of Christ. Because I don't want to say anything on my own account. No quiero decir nada yo de mi propia cuenta. Quiero que tú hables, Padre. Háblanos. Speak to us. Clear across the board. Speak to us. Because you have a word for us. In the name of Jesus. Amen. You know, God has everything in order. This week I went to a conference, and this conference had a speaker there that shared, you know, we have so much giftedness today. We have so much talent today. And many are gifted and talented, are using it for the glory of God. But you know what? She said, I think what we're missing today in our churches is that we don't have the anointing, the fresh anointing of God. And this morning, my prayer, and then the confirmation came this morning as I walked in, when the servant of God prayed over me, and she said, I pray for anointing over your servant. And I know that was God confirming in my heart that this is what we're needing today, the fresh anointing. But you know what? Before the fresh anointing can come, many of us have been broken. Just like the olive oil, olives are stomped on, and
this morning, a fresh anointing will be here so that we will know that it's not me speaking, but it's the Holy Spirit speaking to each one of us. And I want to say, Happy Mother's Day, Feliz Día de las Madres. Hermanitas preciosas, Feliz Día de las Madres. Calvario 2017. Mothers, madres, ¿sabían ustedes que ustedes tienen unas flechas en sus manos? Did you know that you all have arrows in your hand, mothers? God, give me a break. What are you talking about? Well, I'm going to read a portion of scripture. We're going to read it up there. And I want you to read it with me because I want you to see how the Word of God says, guess what it says? It says that we as mothers have arrows in our hands. Arrows in the hands of a mighty warrior. How many of y'all know that we're in spiritual warfare? Yes or no?
Yes.
Or are we tiptoeing through the tulips? Estamos tiptoeing por las tulips? We're in spiritual warfare.
Yes, we are.
And there's somebody after us, day and night. Sometimes even when you're asleep, he's after us. Aun cuando estamos dormidos, el diablo trata de tirar dardos. Y nosotros estamos en guerra espiritual, pero por eso es que estamos preparando nuestras saetas. In Spanish, it's kind of a different word. La palabra es saeta en español. It's arrows in English. And I want to see, read this portion of scripture with me, because children are a what? A heritage from the Lord. They're the offspring and a reward from who? From Him. Like arrows in the hands of a mighty warrior, are children born in one's youth. Blessed is the man whose quiver is full of them. They will not be put to shame when they contend with their opponents in a court. You know what? These arrows that are in our hands, these arrows that are in our hands. I don't need that, do I? Am I connected? No? Here?
Now you are.
Am I connected now? Yeah?
You're connected to the Lord.
I'm connected to the Lord, but I don't know about this. Jesus, to walk with Jesus. know what? God wants to use your arrows to penetrate darkness.
Yes, yes.
Let's describe an arrow. The next one. What does an arrow look like? You all know what an arrow looks like. Ustedes saben que es una saeta, es una flecha. Okay? An arrow has a point. ¿Verdad? Got a point. We spend a lot of years sharpening that point. Right? Because the sharper the point, the greater the penetration into the darkness.
All